Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Let's Crack NEET PG. And myself, Dr. Apurva Mittal, and I'm your educator for anesthesia on this prestigious platform for Unacademy. And today we'll be discussing a very important topic, that is approach to ABG. Guys, am I audible and clear? Okay. Am I audible? Yeah, so today we'll be discussing about how to approach a ABG. That is a very important topic. Today I'll be just talking about the basics of ABG, okay? And tomorrow we'll have a case scenarios and then I'll ask you the question. So tomorrow we'll have a MCQ session. Okay, so before starting our today's topic, let me introduce you Unacademy. Unacademy is India's leading platform for online courses. And by installing the Unacademy learning app, you'll be able to avail the classes of special classes, and also you'll be able to avail classes from the top educators of India like Dr. Pavan, Dr. Zainab, Dr. Rajesh and Dr. Preeti. So in Unacademy, on Unacademy platform, we have two subscriptions, that is Plus subscription and the Iconic subscription. Now, what are the advantages of the Plus subscription is on Plus, by getting the Plus subscription, right, you'll be able to avail the live classes for the 19 subjects, also live tests and quizzes, through which you'll be able to know what type of questions are asked and also where do you stand, okay? And the batch courses and the structured schedule. The batch courses, they are formed so that there will be regular revision also, and the structured schedule so that you don't miss upon any important topic from the 19 subjects. Also, a very good subscription, that is Iconic subscription. In addition to advantages of the Plus subscription, in Iconic subscription, there are advantages because it is associated with Prep Ladder, in which we have video lectures from the top faculty. The question bank, in which the questions which have been asked earlier or the probable questions that can be asked are there. Rapid revision courses. Revision is very important to crack any exam, and also the handwritten notes. So these are the advantages of the Iconic subscription. Now, the Iconic subscription, as I told you earlier also in the previous classes, you can avail it for 1 year, 2 years or 3 years. And I would advise, like if you're in the third year or the second year, I would advise you to go for this, the 2 year or a 3 year course, so that you have regular revision also and also the test. And if you're in internship, go for a 1 year course. And in this, if you apply my referral code, that is Apurva Life, you'll get 10% discount. Okay, so if at 1 year course, if it is for 55,000, if you apply my referral code Apurva Life, you'll have a benefit of around 4,000 rupees. And the Plus subscription, that you can avail even for a month or a 3 month, in that you'll have a revision batches also for 1 year or 3 year or 2 year or 3 year. And here also, if you apply my code, that is Apurva Life, you'll get 10% discount. So this is about the subscriptions on the platform of Unacademy for the NEET PG. Now, let's start our today's topic, that is basics of ABG analysis. Okay, so guys, are you with me? Is the video and audio clear? Should I start with today's topic? Okay, so the ABG analysis, in this I will tell you how to approach a ABG. Okay, kya kya cheeze dekhni hai, how to come to a diagnosis by seeing the ABG, and what all things you should consider while seeing the ABG. Okay, so before that, what is ABG? Why is arterial blood gas analysis done? What is arterial blood gas analysis? Okay, So arterial blood gas analysis is, it is a diagnostic procedure. Okay, remember, it is a diagnostic procedure in which the blood is obtained from an artery directly by either you are puncturing the artery and taking out the blood for the diagnosis, or it the blood is assessed by a way of indwelling arterial catheter. Okay, so blood is obtained from the artery, therefore it is an arterial blood gas analysis. Now, what is Ellen's test? Please remember, Ellen's test ke upar kafi questions aate hain, theek hai? Now, why is it done? That is also asked. So, mostly, hum log blood kahan se le rahe hain? Radial artery se lete hain, right? While taking the blood sample, there are chances that we might injure the radial artery. So, to make sure that the ulnar artery or the collaterals, okay, they are patent, so that the blood circulation is maintained, we do the Ellen's test. Okay, so the test, Ellen's test, is done to determine that the collateral circulation is present from the ulnar artery in case there is thrombosis or injury to the radial artery when we are taking the sample from the radial artery. Is it clear? So how Ellen's test is done? Okay, in the Ellen's test, first we, ask the patient to clench the fist, okay? Clench the fist, and then what we do is we occlude both the ulnar and the radial artery. We occlude both the ulnar and the radial artery. Now, we keep occluding the radial artery and release the pressure from the ulnar artery. So, jab humne pressure from the ulnar artery kiya, तो क्या होगा, ये जो ब्लास्ट हैंड है, देयर शुड बी, इफ द ब्लड सर्कुलेशन इज ओके, सो इट शुड टर्न पिंक इन कलर. सो व्हेन द अनर आर्टरी इज रिलैक्स्ड एंड इफ द कलर इज ऑब्टेन, द पिंक कलर इज ऑब्टेन, दैट मींस द कोलेटरल सर्कुलेशन इज पेटेंट, द कोलेटरल सर्कुलेशन इज प्रेजेंट. एंड आइडियली द एलियंस टेस्ट शुड बी डन फॉर ऑल द पेशेंट्स बिफोर टेकिंग द सैंपल, बिफोर टेकिंग द सैंपल. इज इट क्लियर? Is it clear? Doubts, guys, any doubts in this? Ellen's test is very important. They always ask, why is it done? Okay, so Ellen's test is done to determine the collateral circulation from the ulnar artery in case the thrombosis of the radial artery occurs. Agar Ellen's test negative hai, okay, if the collateral is not there, then we won't take the sample from that radial artery. We will go for another hand. Okay, so that is why Ellen's test is done, and this is a very important test. Guys, is it clear? Okay, please give me a thumbs up if you understood Ellen's test. Questions have been asked from this test. ठीक है, और रिमेम्बर, अगर तुम लोग इसके पीछे का फंडा याद रखोगे तो यू विल रिमेम्बर, यू हैव टू रिलीज द प्रेशर फ्रॉम द अल्नार आर्टरी. ठीक है, कभी कभी वो लोग कंफ्यूज कर देते हैं, एंड यू गो दैट यू हैव टू रिलीज द प्रेशर फ्रॉम द रेडियल आर्टरी. नो, यू हैव टू रिलीज फ्रॉम द प्रेशर फ्रॉम द अल्नार आर्टरी टू सी, ठीक है, कि कोलेटरल्स पेटेंट है कि नहीं. ओके, आई एम नॉट गेटिंग एनी रिस्पॉन्सेस. Okay, fine. So, what are the steps while doing an ABG? Okay, the first is you have to do an Ellen's test, and then you have to take an arterial blood sample. Remember, you have to take arterial blood sample. Okay, so, and if possible, if it is possible, you should try to take the arterial blood sample at the room air, and after taking the sample, if the patient was on oxygen supplementation, start the oxygen supplementation immediately, and the radial artery is preferred. And by taking the sample, you should avoid the air bubbles and cool the sample immediately if the transport is necessary. So this is just simple, that you have to make sure that it is an arterial blood sample. Now, what are the potential sampling error? This is the question asked. So jab tum log arterial blood sample lete, to ho sakta hai ki you have taken very less amount of blood or the sample, and there it is more contaminated with air. So what will happen if there is air contamination? What will happen? There will be spurious increase in partial pressure of O2. So it will give us the false value. Okay. Now the duration of exposure, if there is air bubbles, what will happen? The duration of exposure, kitni der ke liye wo sample exposed the air bubbles ke liye, that is more important rather than the volume of the air bubbles. And if air bubble is present, expel. Dr. Bhatt, I have already started the session. Okay. Guys, is video and audio not clear? Because someone is asking me when will I start the session. I have already started the session. It is streaming. Okay, so when you are taking the sample, if there is any air contamination there. Okay, air contamination, there can be spurious increase in the PO2. Then you have to see the duration of exposure. Thank you, Dr. Sangwa, for making this clear. Others, I hope the video and audio is clear. This is a very important topic. Okay, fine. So the potential sampling error, there can be air contamination, right? The duration of exposure is more important, as I told you, and if the air is present, expel it immediately and discard the sample if the froth is present. So these are the potential sampling error. I'm going through this slides fast because it is just the introduction. Now the venous sample, okay, as I told you that it should be arterial sample to know the arterial blood gas analysis. Okay, now how will you know that it is not arterial? Kyun artery se blood lena, it is more difficult to get it is more difficult than to get blood from the venous, okay, from the veins. So there are possibilities that you are taking the venous sample, so that will give you the false values. So when will you come to know that it is a venous sample? If artery kya hota hai, uske andar pulsatile blood flow hota hai, right? So whenever you will prick the artery, there will be flash of blood. So in the venous sample, there will be absence of flash of blood on entry into the vessel and absence of pulsation. So if these two things are there, then you should consider that it is a venous sample. Now ek aur cheez hoti hai ki jab hum ABG lete hai, ठीक है, तो हम उसके अंदर एंटीकॉगुलेंट, अ वेरी स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ एंटीकॉगुलेंट इज एडेड टू प्रिवेंट द कोगुलेशन ऑफ द ब्लड, राइट? तो एंटीकॉगुलेंट इफेक्ट से क्या होता है, देयर कैन बी डाइल्यूशन एरर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस देयर इट कैन लीड टू ड्रॉप इन PCO2 एंड O2. ठीक है, तो एंटीकॉगुलेशन से तो एयर की वजह से क्या हो रहा था, देयर वाज स्प्यूरियस इंक्रीज इन PO2. ओके, एंटीकॉगुलेंट की वजह से पोटेंशियल सैंपलिंग एरर क्या होगा, देयर कैन बी डाइल्यूशन एरर. ओके, एंड द सैंपल कैन बी मेटाबोलाइज्ड. ओके, इफ द सैंपल इज एनालाइज्ड लेट और इफ इट इज केप्ट एट रूम टेम्परेचर, देन द मेटाबोलिज्म कैन अकर इन दैट. ओके, नाउ द फर्स्ट स्टेप क्या था, आर्टेरियल सैंपल लेना है. सेकेंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट स्टेप विच यू पीपल, जैसे ही ABG मिलती है तो तुम क्या करते हो, सिर्फ ABG से एनालाइज करना शुरू करते हो कि पेशेंट को प्रॉब्लम क्या है. नो, ऑलवेज बिफोर सीइंग द ABG ऑलवेज टेक अ प्रॉपर हिस्ट्री एंड डू अ क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन. गाइस, दिस स्टेप इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, दिस स्टेप इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ऑलवेज बिफोर सीइंग द ABG ऑलवेज टेक अ प्रॉपर हिस्ट्री. From the proper detailed history, many things will come clear. Okay, tomorrow in a class I'll give you an example, as it was asked in the AIIMS question also. The ABG was looking absolutely fine, But from the history only, we were able to come to our diagnosis, and that was asked in AIIMS question. So therefore, I'm telling you should always take a detailed history. Okay. So if the patient complains that he's having vomiting, so yes, Dr. Sangwa, you are telling that samples carry ice pack. I'm telling sometimes, okay, in the peripheries, okay, sometimes in the peripheries, they just carry the sample without the ice pack, and in that the metabolism can occur. So you have to be careful. It is just a source of error. Okay, sorry, samples aise collect nahi karte aur aise carry nahi karte. If at all it is carried without an ice pack, it can lead to metabolism. I'm just telling that. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. So the next step is in the ABG is you should take a detailed history and do a proper clinical examination. Okay. If the patient complains of vomiting, to kya hoga? There is loss of HCl. HCl kya hai? Acid. Okay. So you are losing a large amount of acid. So the primary problem can be metabolic alkalosis. So sirf history ko dekh ke, theek hai, sirf history leke, you can have an idea that because of vomiting, patient might be suffering from metabolic alkalosis. Agar aise patient bolta hai diarrhea, to diarrhea mein kya hai? There is loss of bicarbonate ions. So the primary problem might be metabolic acidosis. So that's why I'm telling, take the proper history properly. And also by getting the history, you will be able to have interpretation of serum electrolytes, and that will give us accurate estimation of the mixed acid base disorder. So always take the detailed history very carefully, because the cause of metabolic acidosis, the cause of the alkalosis, you might come to know from the history. And remember this point, you don't have to just treat ABG. ठीक है तुम्हें सिर्फ ABG like you just don't have to treat acidotic problem or the alkalotic problem. You have to treat the primary cause. So therefore you should know the history of the patient. Okay, you have to know the history of the patient. Like if the patient is having diabetic ketoacidosis, ठीक है तुमने अब उसका acidotic part तो ठीक कर दिया मगर उसका शुगर लेवल ठीक नहीं किया. सो द पेशेंट विल हैव अ रिकरेंस, राइट? सो देयरफॉर टेकिंग द प्रॉपर हिस्ट्री इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इज इट क्लियर? ओके, देन द थर्ड स्टेप इज ऑलवेज हाउ विल यू नो द एबनॉर्मलिटी इफ यू डोंट नो द नॉर्मल वैल्यूज. ठीक है, सो ऑलवेज नो द नॉर्मल वैल्यूज. सो वॉट इज द नॉर्मल वैल्यू फॉर पीएच? Okay, the normal range, okay, it is always in range. The normal range is 7.34 to 7.45, and for calculation we take it as 7.4. guys, are you understanding? ठीक है, तो pH में 7.34 to 7.45 normal for calculation we take it as 7.4. PCO2 में 35 to 45 calculation के लिए 40, और बाइकार्ब इज 22 टू 26 फॉर कैलकुलेशन 24. 7.4, 40, 24 एंड PO2 इफ इट इज मोर देन 80 दैट इज नॉर्मल रेंज एंड फॉर कैलकुलेशन वी टेक इट एज मोर देन 95. सो फॉर कैलकुलेशन द पीएच नॉर्मल इट इज 7.4, द पीसीओ2 इज 40, बाइकार्ब 24 एंड PO2 लेवल मोर देन 95. सो प्लीज रिमेंबर दीज वैल्यूज विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, द नॉर्मल वैल्यूज. Then only you'll be able to interpret the ABG. Then हम लोगों को ABG मिलता है, हम लोग सबसे पहले क्या करते हैं, हम लोग बस pH देख लेते हैं, acid है या alkalotic side पे है, फिर हम लोग उसका PCO2 देख लेते हैं और bicarb देख लेते हैं. That's it. We just stop over there. But actually before seeing all those things, first of all, as I told you, every time take a proper history from the patient and always check for the validity or the authenticity of the report. Okay, always check the validity of the ABG report, if the ABG report is valid or not. Okay, so what is H plus? H plus ions is equal to, the concentration is equal to 24 into partial pressure of carbon dioxide upon bicarb, and the rule of thumb, it can be asked as a question. Okay, how will you know the ABG which you have got is valid or not? Okay, there might be some errors. ठीक है, तो ABG might give us false value, so therefore always check if it is valid or not. So rule of thumb पे क्या होता है कि at a pH of 7.4, okay, I'm so sorry, at a pH of 7.4, the H plus ion concentration is 40. Okay, at a pH of 7.4, the H plus ion concentration is 40. ठीक है, तो एग्जाम्पल अगर ऑलवेज एंड हाउ विल यू चेक द वैलिडिटी, तो 7.4 पे एच प्लस एन कंसेंट्रेशन शुड बी अराउंड 40. नाउ हाउ विल यू चेक फॉर अदर पीएच वैल्यू, सब्ट्रैक्ट कैलकुलेटेड एच प्लस फ्रॉम 80 एंड दिस गिव्स अस लास्ट टू डिजिट ऑफ अ पीएच बिगनिंग विद अ 7. व्हाट आई मीन इज, एग्जाम्पल इफ एच प्लस इज 24, if the hydrogen ion concentration is 24, so subtract it from 80. Okay, so what we'll get, we'll get it as 56. Okay, so these are the last two digits for the pH. So for H plus ion concentration of 24, the pH should be around 7.56. If it is around 7.3 or 7.4, that means the ABG is not valid. Are you getting my point? Are you getting my point? Guys, please give me a thumbs up. Okay, if you are not understanding, please let me know. Okay, so till now, just the history part I have told, and then I have told how to check the validity. Okay, so H plus ion concentration, if it is 40, the pH is around 7.4. And how to check the validity for other values, subtract the H plus ion concentration. Okay, see, you have to always check the validity of the ABG report. Okay, the pH, okay, the pH should always correspond to, pH corresponds to value of H plus ion concentration, right? So agar H plus ion concentration is 40 in your ABG, the pH should be around 7.4. okay, now if the H plus ion concentration is 24, how will you know, okay, how will you know what should be the corresponding pH for a H plus ion concentration to be 24? So subtract, the simple rule is, very simple, is subtract this 24 from 80, so you are getting 56. Okay, so this is the last two digits of the pH, so the pH should be around 7.56. if the pH is 7.56 for H plus ion concentration of 24, that means the ABG is valid. If the pH was around 7.3 or 7.6, that means the ABG is not valid. Okay, Dr. Bhatt, is it clear? Others, is it clear? How will you check the validity of the ABG report? Okay, they can just ask you if the ABG is valid or not. Okay, now before, one more important thing. Now till now I have told you two important things, the history and the validity. Okay, हम लोग क्या गलती करते हैं, जैसे ही हम लोगों को ABG मिलती है, हम लोग सिर्फ pH, PCO2 and bicarb ion concentration देखते हैं. We never see about oxygen. We should always assess the oxygenation, because especially in ARDS patient, okay, in ABG, we should know the oxygenation of the patient. We should know the PO2, because by getting the FiO2, PO2 value only, we will be able to assess the severity of ARDS. So always, always assess the oxygenation of the patient. So always look at oxygenation, and I'm so sorry. Always look at oxygenation. Always look at the PaO2 FiO2 ratio. Okay, always look at this, because ARDS, according to the Berlin definition of ARDS, we will categorize ARDS as mild, moderate and severe according to the oxygenation. Okay, so in every patient, after getting the ABG, see the oxygenation also, if the oxygenation is proper or not. So the normal PaO2 FiO2 ratio is 400 to 500 at an FiO2 of 0.21, that is at room air, okay, 21%. The PaO2 is normally 100 millimeters of mercury, okay? And if it is less than 400, if the PaO2 FiO2 ratio is less than 400, that means there is some VQ mismatch. So you have to treat that. As I told earlier, that you are not just treating the ABG, you have to treat the cause. Okay, the agar oxygenation kam hai, that means there is some VQ mismatch. Okay, ya fir diffusion ka defect hai, ya fir there is a shunt. Okay, and the ARDS, okay, very important, according to the oxygenation we classify ARDS. So if the PaO2 ratio is less than 300 and in the X-ray we are getting bilateral lung infiltrates, then it is ARDS is mild. If the ARDS is moderate, it should be around less than 200, and if it is less than 100, then ARDS is severe. So depending upon the PaO2 FiO2 ratio, ARDS ko mild, moderate, severe kya hua hai, aur isi ke through hamara treatment, okay, what treatment we should give to a patient, that depends. Okay, so always see the oxygenation. Is it clear? Guys, am I too fast or you are able to understand what I am saying? If I am going too fast, please let me know. Others, please let me know. Okay, I will revise in short at the end of the class what to see in an ABG. But before that, okay, so abhi tak kya padha? History, validity and oxygenation. I told you why it is very important to assess the oxygenation of the patient. Now, jo sabse important cheez hai, jo hum log ABG ko dekh ke hasme karte hai, assess the acid base problem. Okay, assess, no. By seeing the ABG, if it is acidic problem or if there is acidemia or if there is alkalemia. Okay, so always look at the pH. Okay, so if the pH, the normal pH is 7.4, right? If the pH is less than 7.4, then what it is? It is acidemia. Okay, if the pH is more than 7.4, that means it is alkalosis, it is alkalemia. Are you getting my point? So always, first, after you get an ABG, okay, first history, validity, oxygenation, and then see the pH, if it is acidosis or if it is alkalotic. Now, what if the pH is normal? Okay, what if the pH is 7.4? So there are two possibilities. Either it is a mixed disorder and it has been compensated, or it is a normal ABG. Okay, or it is a normal ABG. So look at the pH, and then second thing, after getting the ABG, dusra thing dekhna hai, primary problem. Primary problem respiratory hai ya fir, okay, primary problem. Primary problem kya? Is it respiratory? Okay, or is it metabolic? Or it is metabolic. Okay, so primary problem, is it respiratory or metabolic, that you have to see. Ab respiratory mein kya? There is some problem in the lungs. Hai na? To isko body has mein yaad rakhna, it tries to bring the pH towards normal. Okay, Body always tries to bring the pH towards normal. So if it is a respiratory problem, there is some problem with the lungs, okay, or the patient is not able to, there is some problem with ventilation, okay, the PCO2 value is high because of, or low because of some reason. So kya karega? Body will try to compensate. How? By the renal mechanism. तो हर समय किडनी को कंपनसेट करने के लिए टाइम लगता है, राइट? टाइम लगता है. सो देयरफॉर इफ द प्राइमरी प्रॉब्लम इज रेस्पिरेटरी, इट कैन बी एक्यूट और क्रॉनिक डिसऑर्डर. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? सो द प्राइमरी प्रॉब्लम इफ इट इज रेस्पिरेटरी, फॉर द बॉडी टू कंपनसेट इट, इट विल टेक सम टाइम एंड देयरफॉर इट कैन बी एक्यूट और क्रॉनिक डिसऑर्डर. नाउ If the problem is metabolic, ठीक है, तो इसको compensate करने के लिए क्या होगा? Compensation के लिए lungs act करेंगे. तो क्या होगा? अगर patient का pH कम है, like if it is acidotic, okay, तो bicarb कम होगा, तो body क्या करेगी? It will hyperventilate, है ना? So that the carbon dioxide is washed out. So it is the lungs which are trying to compensate. So metabolic problem ज्यादातर जल्दी compensate हो जाती है as compared to respiratory. Are you getting my point? Are you getting my point? So सबसे पहले pH, then the primary problem if it is respiratory or metabolic, then see for compensation and then see the gaps. Okay. So as I told you before that, doctor Pista is asking me some question, that is ICU, in ICU patient, arterial blood pressure continuous monitoring by arterial line, so take ABG directly, yes or no, doubt clear karo. See, through that invasive line, you I didn't get you. In an ICU patient, there is invasive arterial blood pressure monitoring, right? Yeah, through that cannula you can take the ABG directly. Okay, the arterial line you can take the ABG sample directly. There is no problem in that. That is what is the advantage of having an in situ arterial line. You don't have to go on pricking the patient. Okay, and one of the indication to put a invasive arterial line is when you are suspecting that you have to take regular ABG. Okay, so in that it is better to put a invasive arterial line rather than pricking the patient. Okay, bar bar. Is it clear, Dr. Sangwa? Okay, so as I was telling you, ABG mila, first see what the pH, okay, if it is acidotic or if it is alkalosis. So in acidotic, what will happen? The pH is less than 7.4, and in alkalosis, the pH is more than 7.4. Then second step, what we have to see is you have to see the primary problem, if it is metabolic and respiratory. So how will you know if the primary problem is metabolic or respiratory? So simple funda is if the pH, okay, if the pH and bicarb, if it is in the same direction, okay, if it is in the same direction, for example, if the pH is low and bicarb is also low, that means if the pH is less than 7.4 and in the ABG the bicarb is less than 24, that means it is in the same direction. Okay, so it is a metabolic acidosis is the primary problem. Are you getting my point? Are you getting my point? So if the pH and bicarb are in the same direction, that means the primary problem is metabolic in nature. Okay, agar pH or bicarb, okay, opposite direction mein, for example, if the pH is less than 7.4 but the bicarb is more than 24, that means the primary problem is what? The primary problem is respiratory in nature. Is it clear, guys? Why? Because pH is equal to bicarb concentration upon PCO2. Okay, so if the pH and bicarb is in the same direction, अगर pH decrease हो रहा है और bicarb भी decrease हुआ है, that means the problem is metabolic. If the pH and bicarb is in the opposite, pH तो decrease है but bicarb की value ज्यादा है, that means the problem, primary problem is respiratory. Is it clear? Is it clear? Others, please let me know if it is clear. So, if it is in the low pH and low bicarb, तो क्या है? Both of them in the same direction. तो क्या होगा? Primary problem is metabolic. What? It is acidosis. Why? pH is less than 7.4. Okay. If the pH is high and the bicarb is also high, is the problem, primary problem, metabolic or respiratory? Is the primary problem metabolic or respiratory if it is high pH and high bicarb? Guys, please answer. Guys, please answer. So, if it is a high pH and high bicarb, then the primary problem is metabolic. And as pH is high, that means there is alkalosis. Right? Low pH but bicarb is high, so kya hai? It is in the opposite direction. It is in the opposite direction. So primary problem kya hai? That is respiratory. And whether it is acidosis or alkalosis, it is low pH, that means it is respiratory acidosis, the primary problem. Okay, and high pH and low bicarb, it is also opposite. So the primary problem is respiratory, and as pH is high, it is alkalosis. It is alkalosis. Is it clear? So ABG में सबसे पहले देखो acidosis है या alkalosis है, फिर देखो primary problem metabolic है या फिर respiratory है. If it is metabolic or is it respiratory? ठीक है. तीसरा step. If the primary problem is metabolic acidosis. Okay, it is not the third step. I'm just telling, if the problem is metabolic acidosis. Okay, so what can be caused? That means there is primary decrease in the plasma bicarb. Okay, now when can it occur? Ya to bicarb bahut zyada excrete ho raha hai. Okay, ya fir bahut zyada utilize ho raha hai. So excretion of the bicarb containing fluids, या तो उसकी वजह से, like for example in case of diarrhea, या फिर utilization of the bicarb. And remember, whenever the primary problem is metabolic acidosis, always look at anion gap. Okay, metabolic acidosis, if the primary problem is, always look for anion gap. Now what is anion gap? Okay, anion gap is equal to the concentration of the sodium minus the, okay, it is the difference between the cations and the anions. Okay, so anion gap is a difference between the cations and anions. Okay, so if the anion gap is high, if the anion gap is high, that means the unmeasured anions, like in case of diabetic ketoacidosis, okay, the ketone bodies which are unmeasured, that are high. So that will give us high anion gap. That will give us high anion gap. And normal anion gap is 12 plus minus 2 milliequivalents per liter. Is it clear, guys? Okay, so if the primary problem is metabolic acidosis, always see for anion gap. If it is a normal anion gap or high anion gap, why? Because the causes of the non-anion gap, okay, in which the unmeasured anions are not high, is different than the causes of the high anion gap. So the causes of the non-anion gap metabolic acidosis, how will you remember, is hard up. Okay, hard up. That is, it is because of hyperalimentation or hyperchloremia. Okay. Then A is acetazolamide. I'm sorry guys, in this You would ask me in the cations why we are taking only sodium and why we are not adding potassium, because the potassium levels is very less and therefore we just neglect it. So the sodium minus, okay, the concentration of sodium minus the measured anions, that is chloride plus bicarb. Okay, and we to see the concentration of unmeasured anions like the ketones or the albumin. Okay, if the anion gap is high, that means there are unmeasured anions. There are unmeasured anions. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay, I think it will be clearer when I'll be discussing the questions tomorrow. Okay, how to approach your ABG. Today I'm just telling you the steps which you have to see. Okay, so the what are the causes of non-anion gap metabolic acidosis? Isko kaise yaad rakhoge? Hard up. H is hyperalimentation or hyperchloremia. A is what? Acetazolamide. Because of acetazolamide, remember this we see very commonly in the ICU. Okay, R is renal tubular acidosis. D is because of diarrhea. U is uremia, acute uremia, and P is post intubation hypocapnia. Please remember these causes of non-anion gap metabolic acidosis. So because of hyperalimentation, because of diuretic acetazolamide, because of the renal tubular acidosis, diarrhea, uremia, which is acute, and post intubation hypocapnia, these all can lead to non-anion gap metabolic acidosis. Is it clear? Okay. Now, what are the causes of raised anion gap metabolic acidosis? That means there are unmeasured anions, right? So the cause, the acronym is mud piles. Okay, mud pilers. Okay, so M say methanol, in methanol poisoning. U say uremia, chronic. D say diabetic ketoacidosis. P say paraldehyde poisoning, I say isoniazid, L say lactate, E say ethanol or ethylene glycol, R say rhabdomyolysis or renal failure, or S say salicylate. So if in a ABG you are seeing if it is a metabolic acidosis, okay, then you measure the anion gap. Okay, so ek ABG hai, usme pH, matlab you saw that the primary problem is metabolic acidosis. Okay, so always look at the anion gap. Okay, if the anion gap is normal, then it is those causes. If it is high, okay, so after getting the history and after seeing the anion gap, you will come to know there are causes. The patient is unconscious, okay, and there is some history of intake of this drug. So you can come to know ki ho sakta hai ki usne ethanol, okay, there can be salicylate poisoning, okay, or there can be methanol poisoning, ethanol. So through the history and by seeing the ABG and by seeing the anion gap, you can come to a diagnosis. Okay, now if the primary problem is metabolic alkalosis, that means there is increase in HCO3 minus. So gain of HCO3 minus or bicarb ions or extracellular volume contraction, that can lead to metabolic alkalosis. Is it clear, guys? Guys, you are not giving me a thumbs up or you are not telling me it is clear or not. Is it clear? Ya fir sab upar se ja rahe. Okay, now respiratory acidosis. Iska matlab kya hua? pH kam hai, okay, and bicarb is more, okay, it is in the this, okay. So basically the PCO2 level, the, when it is increasing, because pH is equal to bicarb upon PCO2. So if PCO2 increases, okay, pH will decrease. So it is because of the primary rise in the PCO2 level. Now, when can PCO2 rise? So, there is basically alveolar hypoventilation. there is hyperventilation. The patient is hyperventilating. So when it can be? अगर patient बहुत ज्यादा sedated है, patient coma में है, या फिर उसका respiratory center depression है, ठीक है, तो ऊपर से शुरू करते हैं. ठीक है, पेशेंट हाइपोवेंटिलेट कब कर सकता है? सबसे पहले अगर वो सेडेटेड है या फिर कोमा में है. ठीक है, दूसरा क्या सेंट्रल कॉज हो सकता है? बिकॉज देयर इज रेस्पिरेटरी सेंटर डिप्रेशन, राइट. फिर सेंटर से फ्रॉम द न्यूरॉन्स ओके कमिंग टुवर्ड्स द मसल, तो बीच में क्या आता है? देयर इज प्रॉब्लम इन द न्यूरोमस्कुलर जंक्शन. न्यूरोमस्कुलर डिसऑर्डर्स है लाइक मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस. ओके, देन इज इट क्लियर? तो सेंट्रल, देन न्यूरोमस्कुलर, ओके, या फिर मस्कुलर कॉज है. ओके ओके, द चेस्ट वॉल डिफॉर्मिटी, ओके, सो दैट कैन कॉज. और देयर इज प्रॉब्लम इन द अपर एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन और पल्मोनरी डिजीज. देयर इज प्रॉब्लम इन द लंग पैरेन्काइमा. So these are the causes of the alveolar hyperventilation. So kya hoga? There is rise in PCO2 and that can lead to respiratory acidosis. Okay. Now respiratory alkalosis, that means the lung is hyperventilating. So when it can be? Okay. That is hunger like hypoxemia, respiratory center stimulation. Ya fir mechanically we are hyperventilating the patient or in pain or sepsis. These are the causes of respiratory alkalosis. So you should know the causes also so that you can treat that cause. Okay, sirf ye janna ki ABG mein respiratory alkalosis hai ya fir respiratory acidosis hai, that is not sufficient because you have to know the primary cause or primary cause of that metabolic, of that disorder to treat it. Okay, so you should know the examples. Is it clear? Okay, now as I told you, the respiratory disorder, okay, because the body takes time, okay, to compensate it. So it can be acute or chronic. It can be acute or chronic. So how will you know the respiratory disorder is acute or chronic? First, from the history. History se kaisa pata chalega? Like for example, इफ द पेशेंट इज ऑफ COPD, ठीक है, तो वो हमें क्या हिस्ट्री देगा? बार बार हॉस्पिटल एडमिशन होता है, बार बार अटैक पड़ता है, दैट मीन्स इट इज अ क्रॉनिक रेस्पिरेटरी डिसऑर्डर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेक द हिस्ट्री एंड देन सी इफ इट इज एक्यूट. द चेंज इन pH इज इक्वल टू 0.008 into चेंज इन द पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड लेवल्स. ओके, so that is the change in the pH. okay, in the chronic the change in the pH is equal to 0.003 into change in the bicarb in the partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Is it clear? So after we get a ABG to see the acid base disorder, first see if it is okay, first see the pH if it is acid or if it is acidic or if it is alkalotic, then see the primary disorder. Okay, then see the primary disorder is metabolic or respiratory. Okay, if it is respiratory, see if it is acute or chronic in nature. Okay, so these are the steps that we saw till now. Then okay, as I told you, the body, it always tries to compensate. Why? Because to bring the pH towards normal. ठीक है, body हर समय चाहेगी कि pH is towards 7.4. So what will do is, अगर patient को acidosis है तो body will try to increase the pH and bring it to 7.4. If the pH is more than 7.4, the body will try to bring it to 7.4. So body always tries to compensate. So there are certain compensatory mechanisms, and we should always know if the primary disorder has been compensated or not. Okay, so okay, please remember this. Okay, so metabolic acidosis, okay, what is the initial chemical change? Okay, metabolic acidosis mein bicarb kya hoga? If it is metabolic, ठीक है, इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? The pH and bicarb are in the same direction. So pH is decreasing, that means the bicarb also decrease. So initial chemical change is, there is first of all decrease in the pH and there is decrease in the bicarb. Okay, there is decrease in the bicarb. तो बॉडी क्या करेगी, बॉडी क्या करेगी, अगर बाइकअप डिक्रीज हो रहा है तो बॉडी चाहेगी कि कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड को वो वॉश आउट करे, तो PCO2 विल आल्सो बी लेस. व्हाट इज द कंपनसेटरी मैकेनिज्म, बाय हाइपर वेंटिलेटिंग. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट. So what are the compensatory mechanisms? The body always tries to bring the pH towards 7.4. How? अगर primary disorder metabolic है तो क्या, और acidosis है तो क्या हुआ, primary chemical change initial क्या है कि bicarb कम है, तो body क्या चाहेगी कि carbon dioxide का भी wash out हो, तो क्या करेगा, हाइपर वेंटिलेशन होगा जिससे कि पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड भी कम हो जाए, सो दैट द पीएच कम्स टुवर्ड 7.4. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट. सो व्हाट इज द एक्सपेक्टेड लेवल ऑफ कंपनसेशन, रिमेंबर दिस इज वेरी क्लियर, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, द एक्सपेक्टेड पीसीओ टू आफ्टर कंपनसेशन, रिमेंबर after compensation the expected PCO2 is equal to in metabolic acidosis 1.5 into bicarb concentration. Okay, jitna hai plus 8 plus minus 2. Is it clear? For the body to compensate, the PCO2 level should be equal to 1.5 times how much is the bicarb plus 8 plus minus 2. For example, the normal bicarb is 24. Okay, if the bicarb is 20, for example, okay, if the bicarb is 20, so the compensated value of PCO2 should be 1.5 into 20 plus 8 plus minus 2. Okay, so this is 3. Okay, 1.5 into 2 is 30. Okay, 30 plus 8 plus minus 2. So it should be 38 plus minus 2. So the PCO2 value should be around 36 to 40. Okay, it should be around 36 to 40. Okay, so agar by chance the PCO2 value, okay, if the PCO2 value is between this 38 plus minus 2, that means the body has compensated for metabolic acidosis. Are you getting my point? If at all, ठीक है, अगर ये वैल्यू PCO2 की अपनी ABG में, ओके, ABG में अगर PCO2 की वैल्यू वुड हैव बीन 30, दैट मीन्स द बॉडी कुड नॉट कंपनसेट एंड देर इज सेकेंडरी व्हाट, रेस्पिरेटरी अल्कलोसिस अलोंग विथ प्राइमरी मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? बिकॉज द PCO2 वैल्यू इज लेस देन वॉट इट शुड हैव बीन, देन वॉट इट शुड हैव बीन बिटवीन 38. ठीक है, तो इट इज लेस. ठीक है, सो दैट मीन्स देर इज सेकेंडरी रेस्पिरेटरी अल्कलोसिस प्रॉब्लम. ठीक है, इज इट क्लियर? Along with metabolic acidosis. Tomorrow I'll give you more examples in this, but is it clear for now? Guys, please give me a response. This is very important. तुम लोग इसी में question में गलत करते हो. ठीक है, so the ABG, is it clear? Okay, for example, अगर bicarb value 20 होता तो compensated PCO2 should have been how much? 38 plus minus 2. But if in the ABG the PCO2 was only 30, that means the body has not compensated and there is secondary respiratory alkalosis problem. So that is why we need to know the compensatory mechanism also. So in that, we have to treat the primary metabolic acidosis and respiratory alkalosis. Okay, now metabolic alkalosis, what is the primary initial change? Now just tell me jaldi jaldi. So bicarb is primary increase. Compensatory response kya hoga? Body kya karegi? Try to increase the PCO2. That means the body will try to hypoventilate. Okay, hypoventilate. And what should be the expected level of compensation? What should be the expected level of PCO2? Remember, iska just half. Remember something like this. 1.5 say 0.7. Okay, 0.7 plus bicarb plus 22 plus minus 2. Okay, so 0.7 ka 3 times around 22 plus minus 2 should be the compensated value of PCO2. Please remember these formulas, these are very important. Okay, so the level of compensation in metabolic acidosis, the PCO2 value should have been there times. Okay, 1.5 times the bicarb plus 8 plus minus 2, and respiratory alkalosis it is 0.7 plus bicarb, okay, plus 22, sorry, into bicarb plus minus 2. Is it clear? Now what about respiratory acidosis? Okay, respiratory acidosis, always see if the problem is acute, okay, or chronic. Okay, respiratory acidosis hai to kya hoga? Initial chemical change will be increase in PCO2. What will body try to do? Body will also try to increase the bicarb. Doctor, but at your level, you need not know partial compensation. Okay, don't complicate the things at your level. Just know if it is compensated or not. Take your questions if compensation पे पूछा जाएगा कि is it compensated or not, if there is any secondary problem. They won't ask if it is partially compensated or not. At your level, just know these two points, okay? So respiratory acidosis, the initial chemical change will be what? There is increase in the carbon dioxide. What will the body try to do? It will try to increase the bicarb, okay? So in the acute mein kya hoga? Okay, for every, I'm telling, change in PCO2 level by 10 millimeters of mercury for every rise, okay, in the PCO2 level by 10 millimeters of mercury, the bicarb, okay, should rise by 1. Milliequivalent per liter. Is it clear? For example, if the PCO2, okay, in the ABG is 50, okay, normally hum log kya dekhte hain, 40, right? So the compensated bicarb kitna hona chahiye? Okay, so there is rise by 10. Okay, there is a difference of 10. So for every rise of 10, bicarb should increase by 1. So the compensated bicarb value should be 25, because normal we are taking it as 24. I'm sorry, are you able to see here? Okay, the image is coming. My image is coming. For example, iska main example de rahi hu. For every rise of PCO2 by 10, so in the ABG, if the PCO2 is 50, to know if it is compensated or not, the bicarb value, okay, so from 40, the normal, it is increasing to 50. So how much rises there? It is 10. Okay, so bicarb should increase by what? It should increase by 1. So the value should be 25. So if the value of bicarb in the ABG is 25, that means the body has compensated for it. Is it clear? ठीक है, अगर बाई का आपकी वैल्यू ओके बाई का आपकी वैल्यू अराउंड 30 होती, इफ इट वुड हैव बीन 30, दैट मीन्स इट इज मोर देन द एक्सपेक्टेड, इट इज मोर देन एक्सपेक्टेड, दैट मीन्स देर इज सेकेंडरी मेटाबॉलिक अल्कलोसिस अलोंग विद प्राइमरी रेस्पिरेटरी एसिडोसिस. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? ठीक है, सो इन दिस दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल. ठीक है, तो कैसे याद रखोगे? 1, 3, 2, 4 फॉर एक्यूट इट इज 1 and 2, फॉर क्रॉनिक इट इज 3 and 4. ओके, ठीक है, तो फॉर क्रॉनिक फॉर एवरी राइज इन पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ CO2 बाई 10 द बाइकार्ब शुड इंक्रीज बाई 3. ओके, इट शुड इंक्रीज बाई 3. ठीक है, आई एम टेलिंग यू द इंक्रीज. इधर आई वॉज टेलिंग यू द वैल्यू ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. प्लीज रिमेम्बर, ठीक है, रेस्पिरेटरी एसिडोसिस एक्यूट एंड क्रॉनिक. इन एक्यूट, ठीक है, एक्यूट इट इज सी, रिमेम्बर एसिडोसिस. ओके, एसिडोसिस इन एक्यूट इट इज 1. ओके, क्रॉनिक में इट इज 3. इन अल्कलोसिस, अल्कलोसिस में एक्यूट में क्या होगा? फॉर एवरी, ओके, सो हियर क्या होगा? अल्कलोसिस दैट मीन्स द PCO2 इज डिक्रीजिंग, राइट? सो फॉर एवरी 10 डिक्रीज इन PCO2 बाय, ओके, सो बाइकार्ब शुड डिक्रीज बाय 2. फॉर एवरी 10 डिक्रीज द बाइकार्ब शुड डिक्रीज बाय 2. ओके, एंड इन द क्रॉनिक फॉर एवरी 10 डिक्रीज इन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाय 10 द बाइकार्ब शुड डिक्रीज बाय 4. इज इट क्लियर गाइज? इज इट क्लियर द कंपनसेटरी मैकेनिज्म्स? प्लीज लेट मी नो इफ इट इज क्लियर. सो दीज आर द कंपनसेटरी मैकेनिज्म्स. टुमारो आई विल गिव यू ऑल द एग्जांपल्स, ठीक है, टू सी इफ द बॉडी हैज कंपनसेटेड और इफ देयर इज एनी सेकेंडरी प्रॉब्लम अलोंग विद इट. ठीक है, ओके, देन लास्ट यू हैव टू सी द गैप्स. ओके, एंड इंपॉर्टेंट, ओके, इंपॉर्टेंट इज अ डेल्टा गैप. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सी द अनायन गैप. एज आई टोल्ड यू इन मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस व्हाट इट इज, इट इज द मेजर्ड कैटायंस माइनस द मेजर्ड अनायंस. ओके, माइनस द मेजर्ड अनायंस, एंड इफ द अनायन गैप इज हाई दैट मीन्स, ओके, दैट मीन्स देर आर अनमेजर्ड अनायंस विच आर प्रेजेंट. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज एडजस्टेड अनायन गैप? एंड वी सी वेरी कॉमन प्रॉब्लम इन द आईसीयू पेशेंट्स. आईसीयू पेशेंट्स में क्या होता है? देर इज लॉस ऑफ एल्ब्यूमिन. ओके, आईसीयू पेशेंट्स में क्या होता है? देर इज लॉस ऑफ एल्ब्यूमिन. सो वी शुड ऑलवेज सी द एडजस्टेड अनायन गैप. तो अगर क्वेश्चन में एल्ब्यूमिन वैल्यू दिया है, ऑलवेज सी द एडजस्टेड अनायन गैप. ओके, सो एडजस्टेड अनायन गैप रिमेंबर इज, ओके, कैलकुलेटेड अनायन गैप प्लस 2.5 × 4 माइनस सीरम एल्ब्यूमिन इन ग्राम परसेंट. ओके, नॉर्मल एल्ब्यूमिन लेवल इज 3.5. सो इफ द पेशेंट इज हैविंग 2 as the albumin, so the if the calculated albumin anion gap, for example, okay, if it is 20 or if it is 12, okay, plus 2.5, 4 minus 2, so 12 plus 2.5 into 2, so that is around 12 plus 5, so that is around 7. Okay, that is around 17. So it is actually normal. It is not a high anion gap. So always see for the adjusted anion gap in case if albumin value is given. In case if albumin level is given. Okay, for actually main is it clear? Then there is something which is known as MASH, acid-base disorder. ओके मिस्ड एसिड बेस्ड डिसऑर्डर. सो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू सी व्हाट, ठीक है, यू हैव टू सी द डेल्टा गैप. ओके एंड क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम डेल्टा गैप. व्हाट इज डेल्टा गैप? दैट इज एनायन गैप माइनस 12 अपॉन 24 माइनस बाइकार्ब कंसेंट्रेशन. ओके सो सी द डेल्टा गैप. एंड व्हाट इज डेल्टा गैप? इफ द डेल्टा गैप, ओके, इफ इट इज लेस देन 0.4, okay, if the ratio is less than 0.4, that means it is pure non-anion gap metabolic acidosis. Okay, there is no mixed disorder. If the delta gap is between 0.4 to 0.8, that means it is mixed non-anion gap metabolic acidosis plus there is a high anion gap metabolic acidosis component also. So always see for a delta gap also. Okay, if it is between 0.8 to 2, that means it is a pure high anion gap, and if it is more than 2, that means it has high anion gap metabolic acidosis plus there is metabolic alkalosis also, and tomorrow I'll give you examples for this also. Is it clear? So to summarize for today's class, okay, so ABG, okay, whenever we are getting a ABG, always first take the history, okay, check for validity, if it is valid or not, always look for oxygenation, okay, if the PaO2, FiO2 ratio is normal or is it decreased, then look if it is acid or alkalotic, okay, if the pH is increased or it is decreased, then always see for the primary problem, okay, if it is metabolic or is it respiratory, okay, if it is respiratory, see if it is acute or chronic or mostly apne level pe, theek hai, neat pg exams mein through history only you can come to know if the primary problem is acute or chronic. Last, okay, then you have to see for compensation, if it is compensated or there is any secondary disorder. Then you have to see the gaps, you have to see the anion gap and delta gap. Okay, then only you will be able to answer the questions properly. Is it clear? Any doubts? So these are all that you have to see in an ABG. Okay, any doubts in this? Tomorrow at 11 a.m. we will solve the questions. Okay, we will solve the questions on ABG. I'll give you a scenario. You have to tell me the causes and what is your diagnosis on the ABG and how will you treat that patient. So tomorrow at 11 a.m. on YouTube, we will solve the questions on ABG. Okay, around 10 questions we will solve. Is it clear? Any doubts? So please go through all these points and please go through the compensatory numerals so that it will be easier for you and you will gain confidence tomorrow. Okay, and it will be clearer. Is it clear? Okay, and also tomorrow, that is on 10th of Jan at 5 p.m. you have a battle, that is a NEET PG quiz battle. Please enroll in this battle. Why? In this quiz, for this quiz, because you will come to know how the questions are asked. And in this, the questions are set up by the top educators, okay, who are very experienced. So this will actually help you. And please enroll now if you have not enrolled. And the best point is the registration is free. Okay, it is free. Okay. And use my referral code, okay, for the registration. You can use my referral code APURVALIFE, and enroll now, and I would suggest please take part in this. Okay, and through this you will be able to know where you actually stand, what are your weak points. Okay, so you'll come to know your score and also the leaderboard. Okay, your rank amongst all, and there are amazing prizes. Like the rank one will get an amazing Amazon voucher of 40,000, similarly rank two of 20,000, rank three 10,000, and from rank four to 100 there is an amazing voucher of 1,000 rupees. So you use my code, that is Apoorva Life, and please enroll now and take part in this quiz. So that was all for today's class. Thank you. Okay, and as you know that on the YouTube we have a channel, Let's Crack Neet PG. Okay, Crack Neet PG. Please subscribe to this channel and click the bell icon to know the notifications when will be the classes held, and like my video and use my code, referral code Apoorva Life, for the plus and iconic subscription. And also on the Telegram app we have a channel, that is Let's Crack Neet PG. Okay, and you can join this forum, and through this you'll come to know when are the classes held, what are the topics, and also you can ask your doubts. So that was all for today's class. Meet you tomorrow at 11 a.m.